Gulf War illness, or Gulf War syndrome, depending on how you basically word it. A lot of people don't realize between 1990 and 1991, right now about one-third of our military personnel that served at that time, 700,000, now suffer from this sometimes debilitating condition called Gulf War illness. Now, this is what the researchers did. The University of California, I should say San Diego School of Medicine, and in funded with the Department of Defense, there was an interesting angle they put on it. In a study titled, Coenzyme Q10 Benefits Symptoms in Gulf War Veterans, results of a randomized double-blind study published in November issue of Neural Computation, they picked up a few clues and ran with it. The clues the researchers looked at was this. In their mind, or their idea, they said evidence instead links Gulf War illness to chemical exposures. This is a quote from the study. Such as pesticides or pills given to soldiers to protect them from possible nerve agents. These chemicals can damage mitochondria, which generate the energy our cells need to do their jobs when their powerhouses of the cells are disrupted. It can produce symptoms compatible with those seen in Gulf War illness. Now, there was the clue. What happened was the energy in the mitochondria of the cell somehow had been disrupted. What better supplement to help than potentially Coenzyme Q10. So this is where they ran with it next. They took 46 participants. 46 United States Gulf War veterans participated in the randomized, double-blind, placebo-controlled study. Now, the researchers were even surprised to the extent of the benefit that was derived. In their words, the statistical significance of these benefits, despite the small sample size, underscores the large magnitude of the effects. What were the effects? Well, the effects were this. This is just from 100 milligrams of what they said was a high-quality CoQ10 per day, and it was dose-dependent. If they went up to 30 milligrams, they got even better. But this is what happened at the 100 milligram level. Over the course of 3.5 months, the veterans in the study received a pill form of either CoQ10 or a placebo, placebo being nothing. Researchers found 80% of those who received 100 milligrams of CoQ10 had improvement in physical function. The degree of improvement correlated to the degree in which CoQ10 levels in the blood increased. In addition, the research reported that Gulf War illness symptoms, like headaches, fatigue, with exertion, irritability, recall problems, and muscle pain, also improved. So if you have any friends out there who have potentially Gulf War illness, or maybe even any issues with mitochondria, a real good potential solution may be CoQ10. In my mind, all the Gulf War, or all the veterans that served in the Gulf War should be getting this supplement free, i.e. the Veterans Administration. But that's just my opinion. This is Ralph Turchiano, signing off once again, and I hope this helps. Thank you.